Hi, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for watching and for subscribing. And if you're just visiting, please consider subscribing. So today I'm starting a series of videos on my channel where I will rank top 10 fragrances from different houses. Now, obviously, I'm only going to do this video for houses where I've tested or tried a lot of the fragrances or majority of the fragrances. So there will be probably, I'm guessing, 3 or 4 videos in this series. And I want to start it with a very well-known niche house. That's the house of Maison Francis Kurkdjian. Of course, I don't have full bottles of all of these fragrances. I do have a few, but I have tested and tried, I think, majority of the fragrances from this house and have formed very solid opinions about them. And so I want to share with you my top 10 list. So let's start with number 10. And in number 10, I have the famous or the infamous Baccarat Rouge 540. Now, you know my opinion about this fragrance. I've never been a huge fan, although I never hated it either. The reason I put it in number 10 spot, although I know this is a must-have for many, and this is a big favorite of many, is because in my opinion, it's kind of, I'm tired of it. Honestly, I feel like we've seen it so many times. We've talked about it so many times. We've seen so many fragrances similar to it, or dupes, if you want to call. It's just, there's been too much of Baccarat Rouge at this point, at least in my opinion, combined with the fact that I'm not a huge fan of this scent, and I'm not even going to go into notes or anything. We've all heard them so many times. We know what it smells like, so I'm not even going there. But I put Baccarat Rouge in number 10 spot. And I am talking about the Eau de Parfum. Extrait de Parfum will come on later on the list. In number 9 spot, I have Feminine Pluriel, or if I'm pronouncing it correctly. Now, this one is a nice light floral scent, but again, because I'm not a huge fan of florals, it's not my favorite at all. There's iris, rose, violet, lily of the valley, vetiver, patchouli, jasmine, orange blossom. Well, you can see it's an array of floral notes, and it definitely feels floral, although, you know, the florals are not heavy in here. It's a light floral scent. I can see how this would appeal to many, actually. But what I am getting in here is almost slight herbal elements. I don't know why, but it's a little bit herbal and it's a little bit soapy for me. For me, it's not even that I get a lot of flowers, because yeah, there are flowers in here, but like I said, they're very mild. It's more that I get herbal elements and I get soapy elements from this, why it's not one of my favorites and why I put it in number 9 spot. In number 8 spot, I have A La Rose. I used to have all of these samples. Like I said, some of them have been passed on to other people, or I've used them up. And you know, I'm a big fan of rose scents. But A La Rose for me just doesn't work. It's really not my favorite rose scent. And I mean, Francis Kurkdjian is a master of creating rose scents. This one, it seems very, very simple. Two, it seems a little old-fashioned to me. Like, I'm getting vintage vibes from A La Rose. And so for that reason, I am not a huge fan, and that's why I put it in number 8 spot. In number 7 spot, I might surprise you, but I put Oud Sutton Mood. I think this is a gorgeous, gorgeous oud and rose fragrance. It is really, really beautiful. It has rose, it has oud, it has vanilla, it has iris or violet. What does it have? Violet, it has benzoin. It's very thick. It's very rich. It's very strong. And that's why I put it in number 7 spot, because it's beautiful. It has beautiful scent profile, nice oud in here, nice balance of everything else. But I feel like sometimes it's too powerful for me. It is just too much. I find it a little bit overwhelming for me. So although I really like the scent profile and I think it's done beautifully, I find it overpowering and I really have to be in a mood to wear it. So that's why Oud Satin Mood gets number 7 spot. Now in number 6, I have Baccarat Rouge 540 Extrait de Parfum. Now I enjoy Extrait de Parfum so much more than I enjoy the original 540. Yes, they have a similar scent profile, but there is something in the extract that I love so much more. I feel like it has a slight kind of nutty or almondy touch. I'm not sure, but oh, there is a bitter almond in here. There you go. So yes, it's perhaps the almond that's adding it to this fragrance, which for me, although this one is still pretty sweet, but it kind of takes away that cloying element that I get in the original 540, because that's what bothers me in the original the most. It's, I find it way, way, way too cloying. And it's the bitter almond, I think, in here that really takes away that cloying nature of the fragrance. So is it my favorite Maison Francis Kurkdjian? No. Do I have a full bottle? I don't yet. And mostly I don't have it because it's ridiculously priced. It's so, so expensive. And I know that this is not a fragrance that I would wear every day. Again, this type of fragrance I have to be in the mood for. But whereas I will not and cannot wear the original 540, I can definitely pull this one off. And so we're down to the top 5. In number 5 spot, I have Amorous Homme. In general, I would say that the Amorous line, they have Amorous Femme and Amorous Homme, is probably my favorite line of Maison Francis Kurkdjian fragrances. I don't know why, but I really, really enjoy both of these fragrances. And even though this one is marketed towards men, I don't think it's masculine at all. I think this is perfectly unisex, really perfectly unisex. In fact, I have considered purchasing a full bottle of this one, and I very well might do that in the future. So what is this fragrance about? Well, there is mandarin, there is rosemary, there is amorous, iris, there is milk chocolate, which is really interesting. I definitely don't get any milky or chocolatey notes in here. There is coconut, coffee, tonka bean, and there is oud. And it's interesting. I don't get a lot of these notes. In fact, when I smell this fragrance, I'm not even sure what I am getting. I honestly cannot separate this one into individual notes. I really can't. There is a bit of freshness or zestiness. So I can see how there is mandarin. There is a touch of aromatic quality. So yes, perhaps rosemary is playing a role. You know, like I said, chocolate, coconut, coffee, tonka, I'm not getting any of that. To me, this fragrance almost has a little bit of a sparkly or even fizzy kind of nature. Like it's some kind of fizzy drink. I don't know why. Really interesting scent profile. Again, although it has elements of citrus, it's definitely not your average citrusy fragrance. In fact, I wouldn't even classify it as really citrusy. It's just some magic blend of these notes that creates this sparkly fizzy effect for me. Very refreshing type of scent, slightly aromatic. That's really the best way that I can describe it. Again, cannot break it down to individual notes at all. This is just a blend of something beautiful. Number 4. Well, Number four spot, I have Grand Soir. This is an interesting scent. Wasn't love at first sniff, as some of you who watched me might know. I didn't like this fragrance initially. And in fact, you know, interesting thing is I've heard this from quite a few other people where when they first try it, they really don't like it. They find it quite sharp and masculine. And that's how I felt about it when I first tried it. But this is the type of fragrance that A, has to be tested on the skin because it is much more beautiful on the skin. It just reacts beautifully with the skin chemistry. The skin warms it up and just makes it so much better. That's number one. Number two, for me, this fragrance is not universal. It is not for any time of the year. This is specifically for cold weather. And that is why I put it in number one spot, because it is not very universal. And it's not something that, you know, I fell in love with right away. It's something that I learned to love with some experimentation. So this is an amber scent. Of course, there is also benzoin, vanilla, tonka, labdanum, and it's just all of that mixing together to make it warm, deep, sweet, just very round, very smooth type of amber. It's a beautiful amber scent. I would say there is nothing overly complicated about this amber, but I think that's where the beauty of the scent comes in. It's the beauty is in how nice it smells, given how uncomplicated it is, if it makes any sense. So anyways, Grand Soir lands in number four spot. So in number three spot, I have Gentle Fluidity Gold. And although I love the scent profile of this fragrance, and I could have easily placed it higher, the reason for it being a number three spot is because I don't think it's very unique. This scent profile is similar to other things. That's why it's a number three spot. But this is a really beautiful, elegant, gentle vanilla. I mean, I can see why the word gentle is used in a title. It is gentle. It is elegant. It is not overpowering. It's the type of vanilla that will work for any time of the year. This is the type of vanilla that can even work in heat, in my opinion. To me, it has a slight burnt sugar vibe. That's kind of what I'm getting out of this. I mean, there is, in addition to vanilla, there's amber, musk, juniper berries, coriander, woody notes. I don't know. Majority or many of his fragrances just blend together. I have a hard time splitting them up into individual notes. This is another one like that. I know it's not, maybe it's probably not very helpful to those of you listening and trying to understand what it smells like, but I really have a hard time separating them into notes. He just has a special way of blending notes together, and this is one of those. It's an elegant, gentle vanilla, suitable for any time of the year. That's the best that I can describe it. Number two spot goes to Aqua Celestia Forte. This is an incredible summer scent. He has several aqua lines. There is Celestia, Universalis, and there is one more that I can't, Verte, I think, or something. Anyways, I can't remember the third one, but he has three aqua lines. I've tried all of them, and Celestia is definitely my favorite. There is the regular Aqua Celestia, which smells pretty identical to Forte. Forte is just a little bit stronger. That's why I went with this version. What an incredible, fresh, citrusy summer scent. Again, I've heard some that consider it masculine. I can see that. To me, it is not. Absolutely unisex. And I love it. And my husband enjoys this one as well. So what are some of the notes in here? There is lime, there's peregrine, lemon, mint, blackcurrant blossom, jasmine, mimosa, lily of the valley, musk. So, you know, there are quite a few floral notes as well. I don't really get florals in here. To me, this is citruses, and this is kind of slightly sour, zingy citruses. So I can see the fact that there is lime and lemon. That's exactly what I'm getting. It's not sweet citruses in here. And mint really doesn't add kind of mintiness to this. It's more adds like a breath of fresh air, you know, it adds freshness to this. So gorgeous, gorgeous scent. And you know, another plus about this is, you know, typically these summery citrusy scents tend to be kind of light. This one has very, very decent performance. And so we're down to number one spot. And you know, when I talked about Amorous Homme, I mentioned that Amorous line is actually my favorite line from Francis Kurkdjian. And so it comes as no surprise that my number one from this line is Amorous Femme. This was the first full bottle that I purchased and it remains my number one. I know it is not the most popular scent. It's not the most talked about scent from this house, but for me, it is number one. There is some kind of magic in this scent. It's another one of those scents that I have a hard time describing. It has lemon blossom, it has orange, it has amorous, iris, vetiver, musk, amber. And what exactly am I getting here? I don't know. It's a little bit of mix of everything. It's a bit fresh, a bit citrusy, a bit floral, a bit musky. It's like I said, a bit of everything. The best way I would describe this scent, it's very liquid, it's very smooth, it's very elegant. But again, if I had to use one word, I would say it's very liquid. Gorgeous scent. Try it out. Even though, you know, it has all these different elements, I can't even classify it as floral or citrusy or musky. Yeah, it's a bit of everything. That's the beauty of this fragrance, that you have a bit of everything, and that a bit of everything works together. So anyways, Amorous Femme is my number one from Maison Francis Kurkdjian. I would love to know if you have tried anything from this house and what is your number one. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up and subscribe, and I will see you soon in the next video. Bye.